Tonight, we investigate the ghostly goings-on along two of the most haunted lanes in our city. First, we enter Boggard Lane, where a ghostly woodcutter haunts the lane and one of the houses within it. An old lady has been seen wandering the lonely woods, but more sinister is the ghost of the Boggards. The Boggards lived on the lane and were notorious for playing pranks. Some of them took a fatal turn. It is said the Boggards haunt this very lane that's named after them and have appeared to people who are foolish enough to walk down the lane alone. Hi, welcome back to the channel, Tans and Son at youtube.com. Right, tonight we've got a double whammy for you. A short video, but a double whammy. I'm on Boggard Lane, one of the most haunted lanes in Sheffield. And Xavier is at Bunting Nook on the other side of the city. So what we're going to do, we're going to see if we can ring out in on these two notorious haunted places and see what happens. It's just about going dark, so I'm sort of just off the lane actually, down in the wood. The lane's just above me here, the actual lane itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick the K2 meter on first of all, and I'm going to see if there's any activity on this. It's pretty dangerous around here to walk around, so I'm not going to walk around too far. I'm just going to see if anything reacts to this. Right, okay. What I'll do is I'll put the K2 meter here. I have two cat balls, one there and one at the other side. Right, I'm going to also put on the spirit talker. So we need a signal here, don't we? So let me take my Wi-Fi off, put a mobile signal on, if we can get one here, that is. We are fairly high up, but not, if you know what I mean. We're in the valley, a little bit in the woods. So, although we're quite a way above Ultrabridge itself. Right, we have a signal there. Let's get the spirit talker on. Okay, we're getting a signal. What I'll do is I'll put that there. Turn the volume up. Okay, right. What happened here? The cat ball's going off, by the way. Okay, we might be getting something. We might not. I'll just step away a little bit further away from that. What happened here is the Boggard family. The Boggard family used to live on these premises, on this lane, years ago, and they were pretty notorious. Anyway, they're known to haunt this vicinity where I am now. In fact, the whole lane, which stretches from one side, some private houses down there. One of the houses is haunted by a woodcutter, and at the other end, it's haunted as well, where the cemetery is, and that's where we're going to venture in a bit. Right. Hello. Anybody here? Right, the spirit talker is now on. And that should come out with some words. Usually they're relevant, sometimes they're not. And we'll just see what comes up. Now, my name's Paul. I'm on Boggard. You know Boggard very well because this place is quite haunted. And we've come to see you tonight. There's not many people venturing in a place like this at night. I'm on my own. And I'm looking to make contact with you, if you're here. Whether you've followed me down the lane and come here.
There's more of us.
There's more of us, right, okay. So how many? How many are they? I thought there was just one. Are you saying there's more people haunting this lane? What I was going to say is there's a little bit of a rave going off behind us. You might just pick up a little bit of sound of that. Teenagers.
You heard us.
Well, I can hear them just. So, tell me your name, please. Can I have a name? My name's Paul. My name's Paul. You tell me your name.
I'm making it cold.
Okay, you're making it cold. Well, I can't feel the cold from your, wherever you are around me. I can't feel no cold from you. It's not really a cold night. Tell me a name. Come up with your name. Right, we've got the police helicopter above. Just wondering whether it's keeping an eye on that lot back the other side of the wood there. Maybe not. Okay, the cat ball's not gone off. Just the ones. The one behind me hasn't gone off at all. Whatever that is. Somewhere down here. Oh, it's there, yep. Right. So, I'll just touch it. That's working okay. That's switched on. Just make sure. Okay, the helicopter's coming over. Let's turn the light out. Let's turn the light out.
Speak.
Okay, he's heading away.
Pain.
So, are you in pain? Did you die in pain? Did you die in pain? Tell me. Are you a man, a woman, a girl, boy? Come and give me some indication you're here. We've come to see you tonight, on this lovely spring night. Okay, you've set the cat ball off once. Do you want to set the cat ball off again?
Gaining more energy.
You're gaining more energy. Okay, that's helping. So you're trying to get to me.
Run.
I don't want to run. I haven't come to run. I've come to talk to you. So I ain't going to run. So how about you come and talk to me? I have a K2 meter there, next to the bag. If you go near that, it will enter the lights a little bit higher. It can go to the yellow, orange or pink. I'll know you're here then. Okay, we're just getting a few relevant words come through the...
We occupied this land.
Right, there's a significant piece of information. We occupied this land. They did occupy this land, the Bogards. Or the Bogards, I call them the Bogards, but they call them the Bogards. They did occupy this land. This was their land. So that is very significant to what I want to know. So are you one of the Bogard family? You have a good chance of talking to me tonight, giving me some information of what you want to say. I have quite a few indicators here. I have the cat ball. Perhaps you want to move the cat ball, which is at the side of the tree there. Maybe you want to come to the K2 meter and move that, or speak to me through the spirit talker. Now, I want to try the SL camera. Now, the problem is here, there's a lot of trees around. I'm in the woods, of course. And I don't want it picking up them, so I might give it a crack. Have you anything else to say before I leave?
Uncle,
that's not nothing I need to know.
Recording.
I am recording. I am recording. In a way, I'm recording. Yes, I'm filming. I have a camera here. Can you see the camera? Can you see the light? Yeah. Okay. Thank you for talking to me. I'm a bit disappointed you didn't come out with your name. But there again, we can't have everything, can we? So say one more word for me, then I'm going to close this app down. Okay, we occupied this land. That was very appropriate for here.
Amy,
okay, now we're getting a name. Oh, hello, Amy. Are you with us here tonight? Come and say hello. My name's Paul. You can call me Paul, you can call me Tams if you like. You can call me what you want, Amy. How old are you, Amy? Are you a little girl? So, we've picked up maybe Amy, and we occupied this land. It's both relevant to this, where I am now, Bogard Lane. So what I'm going to do, oh, the cat ball's going off as well. Thank you very much for that. Thank you for moving the cat ball. I just want the K2 meter now on the right to go off.
Agree.
Do you agree as well? So build your energy up. You said you're going to try and build that energy up. you're gaining more energy, you've given me your name, you've set the cat ball off. Now I want you to set this K2 meter off, what I've got in my hand. I want to see those lights go up, Amy.
I was hung.
You was hung and the light's going up. Okay, you're with me now. Where was you hung, Amy, in these woods? You're just starting to light my K2 meter there. You're gaining some more energy. Keep with me, Amy. Right, we're getting a little bit of flicker going up to the green on the K2 meter.
Park.
Little moth there. We're attracted by the light on the camera. Okay, Amy. Thank you for that anyway. You've really helped tonight. Okay, I'm going to leave the K2 meter there. And I'm going to turn the app off. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to put another app on, which is an SLS camera. I've used it on a couple of more the cat ball's going off. Expeditions or ghost hunts. I will point out, I'm not a ghost hunter, but I like to prove or disprove if they do exist. I don't think you can ever disprove it, and I don't think you can actually ever prove it. Right, I've got the ghost tube, now that's picking the tree up. Put the light over there. Oopsie-daisy. Try that again. Okay. The cat ball is going off again. Thank you for that, Amy. Amy, is that you? I do like it when it doesn't pick up, unless there's something. If there's nothing there, it's a lot better when it does pick up. Because that tree's there, but it's not picking the tree up, fortunately. It isn't picking any of the trees up. Okay, I don't know what that's picking up there. Okay, Amy, we could probably pick you up here. If you come close to me, there's something in between those branches there where it's picking up, but I'm not sure what it is. It's hovering around that tree there. Right, okay. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to hand you over to Xavier, up at Norton there, on Bunting Nook. And I'm going to just go over to the other section and see if I can find anything over there, over there where the cemetery is, down there, and give it a go down there. Over to you, Xavier. Have you found anything yet?
Thank you. Cheers, Tans. We're at Bunting Nook, and we've not been here too long, but a cat ball just went off behind us. So we've put three cat balls around us, and that one has just gone off. So we're just gonna have a walk around each of the cat balls, see if any activity happens. And we've also got, we've got the K2 as well. So if you have a look at that, it's pretty bright, but it'll pick up information if there's any electric fields or something that are nearby. So let's walk up here. It's on blue at the minute, which is where it is when you start, when you turn it on. Okay, this cat ball here is the one that went off just before we started recording. Right, okay, we've just turned the big light off. I'm gonna place the K2 next to this stone slab. Put it around there, make sure it don't fall off. So about there. See if we get any activity on that. So we're going to use the SLS app and see, yeah, I'll show you. When you go by, it just showed you a green line. They kind of look like ghosts. Yeah, you might have just seen that then. That might have been me, I think. So we're gonna have another walk around the cat balls, see if we can spot anything. Right, okay. Oh, something just popped up. So you can see it on there, that we're getting some activity. Oh, that looks really weird. All that activity. What's that all coming from? Okay. We never had this much activity when we were using it last. But let's walk further down and we'll see if we can catch anything else. Okay, we've got some activity on the SLS meter and it does look like something is there. We're gonna see if we can have, if any of the cat balls can go off around us, and we're gonna shout to see if there's anyone there that might want to talk to us. So, my name's Xavier. I'm just, first time I've been here really to do some paranormal hunting or exploring, and I'd love for you to come down closer to me, see if you can, well, give me any, I don't know, visible indication that you're here. So that's what you're picking up on the SLS meter, and it's sticking around the same area. It's not going much anywhere else really. Right, so we might go further close to it.
Okay, thank you, Xavier. Glad you're picking something up at Bunting Nook.
Darkness.
Okay. Darkness. Right, I'm going to take this down here with me. I'm going to carry it, in fact. The phone is on flight mode, so it isn't going to interfere with this camera here. Put that there. So darkness, we've got darkness. Yes, it's very dark. It is very dark. We've got five cat balls set up around the place, and also
he killed us.
Right, we got he killed us. Who killed you? Just to let you know, I am at the side of a cemetery, by the way. This is the cemetery gate here. So this is where I want to do any investigation around this area. This is actually on the lane itself. Boggard Lane. So I'm just going to take a little walk round on the lane here and see if I can pick anything up with this K2 meter. You can hear the owl. Right. So the K2 meter is not really having any effect. So I have Manny's pole. Come and talk to me. We're on Boggard Lane. We know apparitions do frequent this lane. It's a very haunted lane. And I want to meet you. I want to come. I want you to chat to me. I want to tell me who you are and what you're doing here, how long you've been here. Now, who killed you? You tell me who killed you. He killed us, so it's a he. You said he. And who's he? What's his name?
I'm over here.
You're over where? Tell me where you are. You're not having any effect on my K2 meter. What I've got in my hand.
I was executed.
You was executed where? Was you hung? Come to my meter, my K2 meter. And tell me who you are. I'm right at the gate. Can you see me? I can hear the owls, that's for sure. Okay. Oh, the cat ball's going off. So that's one going off. Can't see any others. None of the others are going off. Right, okay. Keep an eye on that. There's one actually on the other side of the gate where the steps are down into the cemetery. Right, okay, come and talk to me. We've met Amy already down at the other end. We're now down at this end. Come and tell me, we're on the lane. We're on Boggard Lane. Come and say hello to me. Come on. Right, we've got a bit of flicker there. You need to get some energy up to come and talk to me and set this meter going.
Safe.
Well, I'm safe. I think I can hear music down in the village. That's coming from a local pub, I think. Probably a rock band. Do you like the music? Do you like listening to the music down there? Tell me, do you like music? Right, okay, take that with me. I'm going to walk down the lane. Because it's on the muddy side in places. Right, okay. You're very quiet down this end. Very quiet. Okay, I'm going to give it a final shot. I'm going to put the SL camera on. And then I'm going to...
Albert.
Ah, now we're getting a name. Albert. Okay, Albert. Albert, come and say hello. Do you know Amy? So I'll put a little light down here into the cemetery. Come on, Albert.
Video.
Video, yes, we are videoing you. Well, not you personally, but we are videoing. So it's your chance to come on and talk to us. Right, I'm just going to change all the apps here. Put the SL camera up. SLS camera up. Right, what I need to do is turn the big camera off. Picking something up there. The big light off. Put the small lights on. Right, I'm going to just darken it a little bit. There's something down there. Okay, we're picking something up. Come up the stairs towards me. Come and say hello. Right, I'm going to try the lane. There's nothing on this lane. Nothing on this lane. So if it picks anything up, it's going to pick a figure up. A person. Scan around there. My torch. Okay, nothing on the SLS camera. So we're going to go back and have a final word with the spirit talker. I really, really, really want you to talk to me. I've got 1 minute. So, Albert, are you with me? Amy, are you with me? I could say they're talking through the owl, because every time I ask a question, the owl hoots. They're definitely not that. Right, come and talk to me. We've cleared the screen. Give me a name again. Give me a name. Come on. Tell me who you are.
Bad.
You're bad, or am I bad? No, I'm not bad. I'm a very good person. Are you bad? Why are you bad? What have you done? What have you done? What makes you bad? So I've still got the cat ball set up, and just one's gone off. The others haven't gone off. The K2 meter's still on green at the bottom there. I can just about see it down there. And the spirit talker is fairly quiet on this end. So it's gave me a name. It's gave me a name, Albert. I think that's roughly
wind.
All he said, really. There's no wind tonight. No wind tonight. So I don't know what that is. Maybe there is up where Zabe is, up Bunting Nook, but there's no wind down here. It's as dead as a doornail on this lane at the moment. Which is nice. Look, what I'm going to do, I'm going to pass you through to Bunting Nook. To summarise, on Boggard Lane, we've picked a couple of names up, we've picked a couple of executions up, and she said she was hung. Now, and she also said that they were the landowners.
Forward.
They were the landowners. So there's quite a bit of significant stuff come on this tonight. Not all of it is, but some of it, most of it actually is. So is there a ghost, a haunting on Boggard Lane? Maybe so.
Right, cheers Tans. Sounds really good of what you're getting at Boggard Lane. I'm at Bunting Nook. I've only just got here. I've put a few cat balls around the path, and I've also got my handy care too. So we're gonna have a walk around the cat balls, see what we can pick up. So let's have a little walk round. Okay, so we've got one cat ball here, other cat ball on the stone wall. Okay, let's have a look round. Right, we're not really getting any activity, so let me get my SLS app up and let's have a little walk around. 1 second. Right, okay, we had a slight car coming down, so here we go again. Right, I've got the SLS on and it picks up green lines that could be potential ghost activity. So we'll walk around this path around the cat balls, see if you could pick anything up. Right, I just don't want to stand on these cat balls. Right, so we're not really getting anything round here, but we were just down there a few minutes ago, facing this way, and we ended up picking quite a lot of activity up. Okay, now we are using the Spirit Talker. We've been using it in the past to see what information we can get about this area or different areas, and we'll just have to see what names, see if we can get any names. So let's have a little sit down at this wall and let's have a little chat to anyone that might be around us. So okay, my name is Xavier. It's first time I've been around here, actually. Affair. Okay, it had the word affair, which makes sense because this area is called Broken Neck Lane. So that is quite handy to on the information we really need. We've got two other words that have popped up, mine and the name Thompson. Whether any of them had the name Thompson in the name, we're not too sure. But hopefully we can gather more information. So, right. Anyone out there, could you tell me a little bit about yourselves?
Obvious.
Obvious. What would be quite obvious? What would be quite obvious? Could you please tell me? Did you fall off your horse and end up breaking your neck? How long ago was it?
Photos.
Photos? Right. Don't know what that could mean, photos. I mean, I've not seen any photos of the history of this area. So that's quite of a random one. Is there anything else you could tell me? What else happened? Or if you could give me your name. Anything at all. It's quite spooky while you're waiting for a word to pop up. Because it could be anything. It could make total sense. And it could be completely random. You just don't know. Okay. We've been here quite a while and we've not had that much Information.
Edna.
Edna. Were you named Edna? Right, Edna. Ooh. It's quite of... I mean, I don't know how far back this goes, but that's quite an olden day name, really. So it could. You never know. Let's see if any other words pop up before we... before we end. See if anything pops up. How far back do you go? Could you give me a decade?
I don't mean to scare you.
Oh, that's very creepy, that. I don't mean to scare you. Well, at the minute I'm not too scared because I've not really seen anything. Apart from the green lines on the SLS. But apart from that, I'm pretty good. Could you move any of the cat balls before we end it? His voice. Who's my voice? What about my voice? Do you like my voice?
Great.